Actually, we started off by building a social media application on the Android. So this is the first time we are building an application on the Android. So we chose Titanium SDK for the Android application, and although we were not able to achieve what we wanted to achieve because of some Facebook permissions issue and all. But anyway, so the idea is to compose to multiple profiles. Let's say if you are from a social media agency or you have multiple brands in your company, then you would like to have a place where you want to compose to all these assets or brands to Facebook and Twitter, everything through a common interface. So we try to develop that platform. So I'll just take you. So the product is called JS Social, and so it's an enterprise level kind of application that we try to achieve here. So start by creating a brand. And then what we do is I've actually done all that so that it saves the time, because it asks for login and it's very complex to type all the login information for this. So what it does is basically it goes to the Facebook, it collects all the information, right? It doesn't collect all the information, it asks you for your login and password, and then it asks you to give certain permissions, like these are actually my pages that I'm handling in my company. So these are the pages that are actually retrieved from the Facebook, right? So for that we need certain permissions from Facebook, and we get those permissions from the Facebook, and using their APIs we kind of retrieve the pages, and so basically what we look these are what we call it as assets, and we add these assets, any one of these assets, or you can add multiple assets. So I'll add a couple of assets here. So the asset got added, kind of bug, so it got added twice, but and you can add another asset if you want to. So this data is actually loaded from the Facebook, but the rest of the data is all synced to the SQLite data. So the asset got added. Now what we try to do for this 18 hours is we want to build so the next screen, I'm not sure whether I can get it. I can try one more time. So the next screen will be where you actually kind of compose to the Facebook and the Twitter simultaneously. So let me try just another thing. So it's something like this. We are yet to complete this portion. This is the place where you actually try to compose from in the Facebook and as well as in the Twitter, and there will be brands actually showing, all your assets will be showing up here, so you can customize and tweak them, and then you can also add images and links and anything, and you can also copy immediately to the Twitter and compose both at the same time. So that's the idea. Due to some Facebook permissions issue, it's allowing for login and all, but it is not allowing us to post it. I think we can solve this problem. It's just to the time constraint, we are not able to solve this problem. But this is basically for social media management. for brands and social media agencies. So that's what we try to achieve. So it's pretty much it. Yeah. Any questions or anything?
Why did you choose titanium as a recipe?
Yeah, so we actually quite kind of brainstorming from the last 3-4 days on what to go with. One of the reasons why, there are quite a few, like phone gap, you might have heard of it, where there are a lot, in phone gap, you can easily code, right? The HTML and the JavaScript, it's very easy to code, but at the same time, it has drastic performance issues. So if your application, it loads in kind of an iframe in the application, so which is like, it takes a lot of time for the performance issues are, large in that. So the advantage in the titanium that we found was that it actually, you need to learn a lot more because the syntax is all you can write, like for example, JavaScript is what you know, right, and XML. So, but using these, you need to learn a lot of their API and code in that. And what happens is you can compile them into the native codes of iOS and Android. So ultimately, the application that you get at the end is a actually native application, not the HTML or the JavaScript version of it. So even though if you write in the Java, there's an advantage that you can optimize your code, right? So you can write it in a sleeker way and you can optimize it. Here you can't do it because you can just write the code and leave it to the SDK to actually compile it. But that's the trade-off you can do for the time you can save for coding in two different languages, iOS and the Android. So that's what we found it's interesting and we started learning it from yesterday.
So what other media apart from Facebook and Twitter do you
use? We are also going with Google. The first is Facebook, then Twitter and Google Plus. That's the order we are going with. And we also want to go to LinkedIn. LinkedIn, I think recently has made it public their API. So I think now if someone wants to really code in the LinkedIn, I think there's earlier it was not all the data was given in an API format to the public. Now they are giving a lot more data actually for you to consume. So Facebook is always open, so you always have this liberty to access their API and do it. Twitter is conservative in terms of they don't give any analytics data and all that data, so you need to do your own analytic data after consuming. Say let's say for example daily you need to keep store of the things that are happening and you need to build analytics over it. So it's so that's the order in which we are going because of the freedom that they are giving us in terms of the API. That's Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, and LinkedIn, and maybe in the future, Pinterest.
Just one thing, one question which I had was: are you targeting any specific set of devices for this? Because I'm not sure, some sort of maybe a company would actually use just a normal phone to do their marketing across so many.
Correct, absolutely. So what we have is already a web application that we already built for kind of this. I mean, it's not yet released or launched, but we have a web application which is having a lot more features. It has a lot more engagement. I mean, it's like an enterprise level app that we have been building for over a year now. So this version, we want to also have some kind of interface where, let's say, you don't always want to open your laptop, even though you may be roaming around and you want to quickly put a message, being busy. And so it's always helpful to go with Android and the iPhone, in that order in India, if you are targeting. And I think first is Android in India, and then you have to go for the iPhone as well, because companies and all, they give a lot of free goodies like iPhone and also, those people, if you're targeting companies, you need to also go with iOS. So these are the two main things we're targeting.
Well, I'd asked if are you targeting any specific devices, but I think
I understood.
You sort of answered the query when you said you are going to put a minimal set of features from your app into this.
You are asking about the screen, the Nexus and all that. Yeah, we haven't decided it yet. We didn't go that far, frankly speaking. So I think we will be targeting tablets and smartphones over a bit larger size. That's the target we are doing. And in the future, maybe to all the devices within that. So
now we will support 2.2.
Yeah, this is just a, you know, you can give the minimal support to this app because it doesn't involve, you know, very high fundra stuff. I mean, it's just a web application converted into, you know,